Saramazand, welcome to my late night thoughts on listening to some songs I wrote mostly during the night. All these songs unfold their true attraction best far after midnight when everything is quiet and the thoughts have room to unfold. These songs are a kind of accelerated time equilibrium, a kind of balm for dark souls like mine. I would like to give you a deeper look into the calmer side of the nuns behind all those known video singers like Broken Column, Karma, In Eternal Decay, or Body of Light. However, let's get started. My name is Arthur Seid, and I would like to invite you on this journey to a place beyond. Would I die this way? Would you like to come inside? Feel the ancient cold in a place beyond. I am God, I am known. The song's about the question of all questions: what happens to us after we die? Where does our souls go? How is it? The moment of transformation, of perishing. Someone waiting for us over there, a loved one who have passed away. And my God, it's just nothing. And who came up with it all? What's the plan behind it? If there is one. However, the driving force behind almost all of my lyrics are those big questions. Let's move forward. Here comes three songs in a row, all from Telema, which is one of my favorite Nonce albums. Sit back and relax.
Thank you. unveiling of the company of heaven. Every man and every woman is a star. Every number is infinite, there is no difference. Help me, O warrior lord of Thebes, in my unveiling before the children of men. Be thou Hardit, my secret center, my heart and my tongue. Behold, it is revealed by Ivas, the minister of Hor Parkrat. The Kharbs is in the Khu, not the Khu in the Kharbs. Worship then the Kharbs and behold my light shed over you. Let my servants be few and secret. They shall rule the many and the known. These are fools that men adore. Both their gods and their men are fools. Come forth, O children, under the stars, and take your fill of love. I am above you and in you.
Thank you.
Welcome back, a long journey. I became one with the universe. I can feel its insatiable hunger. The curse of our memories. Witness the fear of galaxies. An aeon pointing the way above the shadow at dawn. All the horizon is gone. I pass the shadows and move on in silence. Well, the whole album was inspired by a trip to Sicily in 2016. Yava and me visited the original ruins of Aleister Crowley's Telema Temple in Cefalù and stayed there overnight in Crowley's Chamber of Nightmares. The experiences and the knowledge about what happened in this place flowed into my lyrics, especially those of the last three songs that you have just heard. The power of the house in which unimaginable things happened occupy me to this day. Let's move a bit backwards to something like a sister album of Telema, Exosphere. The album Exosphere are deeply inspired by themes about distance and unreachability. While writing these songs, I always had an image in my mind's eye that shows a group of giants that humanity follows devotedly. I then tried to give these giants a symbol, a kind of seal, something that could also serve as a protective amulet. Without knowing exactly whether these giants want to protect at all. You can see these giants on the cover artwork for Exosphere, which is for me probably the best Nuns album ever. Maybe there aren't the best songs on it, and certainly not the best known songs, but as a whole this album works very well. Sit back and relax. Here comes Violet Flame. An astral plane.
To the apples watching the watchers die for the games of life. How could I be no longer with thee? Million light years away, a watcher. Did they really come from outer space? I'm lucky. Could they exist in an endless abyss, a million light years away? How could I be no longer with thee? A million light years away. How could I be no longer a violet flame? A million light years away, we are fallen, we are woven. Someday, 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 a million light years away, we are fallen, we are woven. Someday,
how I feel.
stars, they are falling for you. Bless you without fear. Shine on and reappear. It doesn't matter who comes through. Watch the stars, they are falling for you. Bless you without fear. Shine on and reappear. It doesn't matter who comes through. Watch the stars, they are falling for you.
What should I say? Something I wonder about myself, how creative I am and that I never seems to run out of ideas. Here's another track from this album, Passing Bell, probably the best song I have ever written. A passing bell is a bell rung to announce a death or a funeral, also called a death bell. This bell rings in the vastness of the universe for all those who died prematurely. Can you hear all the bells ringing? By moonlit fields, she swallowed down by the grave.
Thank you.
takes to upstand morals. Prophet speaks to upstand morals.
Step back to the very beginning of the Merciful Nuns. What can I say? I want it darker and deeper than anything I've done before. And this next song was the result. From then on, I knew I was on the right path. This is God Aeon. Thank you.
the man of the law, a fool to adore. I am the man on the floor. Explore my blood on the wall. I am the man of the law, a fool to adore. I am the man on the floor. Explore my blood on the wall. Thank you.
Well, I have a lot of memories with this album. Level One was actually born out of a whim to write an album which could have been made in, let's say, 1985. In addition, at the time, I had quite a problem with the copyright infringement and as a result with my record label too. In the end, I decided to form my own label, Solar Lurch, and brought out Level One on my own. Certainly one of the best decisions of my life. Most of the inspiration for my lyrics comes from countless books that deals with various religious aspects. This devotion to man-made illusions has always fascinated me. As the grandson of a Jehovah's Witness, I came into close contact with this topic at an early age, and I suspect that this is also where my strong affinity to early Christian topics came from. I've always been drawn to the original places of faith, all these temples, churches, sacred places, holy monuments, places of worship or ancient sites. It was a logical consequence that I and Yahweh visited these places. And they inspired us, and it flowed into my work, into the lyrics. The next two songs were deeply inspired by a trip to the Middle East, Israel and to Jordan a few years ago. We walked on early Christian traces, reconstructed the temple in Jerusalem, wept at the Wailing Wall, visited the sacrificial sites in Petra, climbed the castle of Masada and drowned in the Sea of Galilee.
Thank you.
through the haze, the essence of darkness, a color fading to shades of gray. For the night sky, you walked away. Resting deep in the dark water. Resting deep. Resting deep in the dark water. Resting deep. Seconds out of control as above, so below. Sinking in shiny armor to the entrance of the golden dawn. Resting deep in the dark water. Resting deep. Resting deep in the dark water. Resting deep.
The lips of wisdom are closed to the ears of understanding. Welcome back again. You're listening to Late Night Thoughts with Arthur Seed. The next song I would like to play is Ceremonial Passage from Xibalba 3. Xibalba is the Mexican underworld. I am particularly fascinated by the Mayan and Aztec culture. Our trip through Yucatan in 2011 and later to the Teotihuacan ruins are among the most impressive we have ever made. Imagine all these great temples in the middle of a huge rainforest. The rites and the rituals are absolutely breathtaking. By the way, you can see your original footage done by myself in Chichen Itza. Please sit back and relax. This is Ceremonial Passage.
Outside of the inside.
This was a ceremonial passage. I would like to end with a very special moment in time for us all here at the Lodge. Our beloved Frater Fiedens dies in autumn 2017. At the same time I wrote this song coming up next. The song was nearly finished, so the lyrics are made without the impact of his death. But I felt the impact in the lyrics without referring to Frater Fiedens. The impact was just there. It unfolded right before my eyes. Here's the morning, here's the epitaph, an anticipated death influenced by a poem of Charles Baudelaire. The sadness of the moon. It was so terrifyingly beautiful that I thought I would stop here with this band. There was nothing more to say. I thought, but I was wrong. I will continue. I will write new Merciful Nun songs. For me, for you, and for Brother Fiedens. In loving memory, I now end with The Pyramid. Thank you very much for listening. Take care of yourself and stay healthy. Thanks, and good night.
Desiring slumber to shun. colors of which like an opal blend, and buries it far from the eyes of the sun. A poet, desiring slumber to shun, takes up this pale tear in the palm of his hand, the colors of which like an opal blend, and buries it far from the eyes of the sun.
Sleep well.
In excelsis.